Developments in the world of 3D printing continue to bring innovations with limitless potential. Businesses with large budgets were once the only ones able to benefit from 3D printing, but now the technology has brought affordable, easy-to-use models within reach, even to those of us on a budget. But with so many models out there, it's not always easy to figure out which is best. In this video, we're breaking down the best three budget 3D printers on the market this year, based on price, performance, features, and situations they'll be used in. So whether you're looking for the best SLA printer or the best FDM printer, we'll have an option for you. So if you're interested in finding out which 3D printer will be best for you, stay tuned. As always, all the links to find the best prices on all the products mentioned in this video will be in the description below. So for the most up-to-date information, along with updated prices, be sure to check out the description. The products mentioned in this video are in no exact order, so be sure to stay tuned till the end so you don't miss anything. First, we'll be taking a look at the 3D Creative Photon 3 Pro, our choice for best budget SLA 3D printer. Up until recently, inexpensive SLA 3D printers were the unicorns of the 3D printing world. For years, there were only a handful of them available to consumers. Now, resin-based printers like the 3D Creative Photon 3 Pro are entering the market. Its price point of less than $250 makes it one of the best budget SLA 3D printers that can get you started in 3D resin printing. A few things make this printer stand out. Most importantly, instead of squirting plastic filament through a hot nozzle to create objects, it shines light into a vat full of photoreactive resin to cure each layer. It's also very small, roughly the size of two shoeboxes sandwiched together, so it'll fit comfortably on your desktop or a shelf. Keep the small size in mind though, because you won't be able to print anything bigger than 4.5 by 2.5 by 6.1 inches with this machine. But the Photon makes up for it with some incredible resolution and accuracy. It's capable of printing layers thinner than 10 microns, making it far more detailed than even the most high-end FDM printers out there. Setting up the Photon 3 Pro is simple. It comes almost fully assembled, so all you need to do is install and manually level the build plate, then attach the resin vat. Once you've completed that, fill the vat with the included resin and you're good to go. Even though this is a budget 3D printer, nothing about it feels cheap. The build plate and resin tub are made from machined aluminum, while the frame is made from stamped sheet metal. But being a budget-friendly printer, it's missing some of the more thoughtful design elements that you might find on higher-end machines, like an automatic resin filler or some kind of peel wipe mechanism, which means you might run the risk of print errors. Still, you're getting a lot of 3D printer for the price. The Photon's onboard UI is about as simple and straightforward as they come. The interface is extremely basic, so you'd be hard-pressed to get lost or confused. Plus, it's all touchscreen, so navigating between menus is highly intuitive. Simply put, if you can use a smartphone, you can use this printer. Even without any prior experience with the program, you'll most likely be able to fire it up and get your first 3D model prepped within just a few minutes. Its complete ease of use and killer price make the 3D Creative Photon 3 Pro one of the best budget SLA 3D printers around. Next, we'll be taking a look at the Creality Ender 3 Pro, our choice for best budget FDM 3D printer. If you're looking for an FDM 3D printer that won't cost you an arm and a leg, at under $300, the Creality Ender 3 Pro is easy to use and produces solid prints, making it one of the best budget FDM printers going. Being an FDM 3D printer, the Creality Ender 3 Pro extrudes a continuous filament of thermoplastic material, and the printhead is moved under computer control to define and build up the printed shape. For a budget printer, it comes with a sizable print area of 8.6 by 8.6 by 9.8, allowing you greater freedom to print substantially larger size designs than with the 3D Creative Photon 3 Pro. The Ender 3 Pro arrives partially assembled with the most complicated parts, like the hot end and the base, already built. But you'll need to finish the frame, add the PSU, mount the Y-axis, and complete the electronics cabling. A full toolkit, including hex keys, a couple of small spanners, a screwdriver, and even some modeling snips is included, so you won't need any additional tools. And a large color instruction sheet breaks down the assembly process in a straightforward way. The build quality of the Ender 3 Pro is made up of an extruded aluminum channel that provides a lot of stability, which is an important factor in getting high-quality 3D prints. Fitment is very good as well, and tolerances line up well. The printhead moves in the X, Y, and Z axis using V-slot aluminum channels and palm wheels that run quiet and produce high-quality prints. Everything sits on a rigid base, meaning that you can move it around without needing to re-level it each time, which is nice, and has a compact footprint that doesn't take up an enormous amount of table space. The Ender 3 Pro features a Bowden-style extruder that lets you print with either PLA or ABS and has a fast heating bed, which is a necessity for printing with these materials and ensures proper adhesion to the bed. For control, a built-in backlit LCD screen gives you access to all the normal lists of controls, like preheating the printer, selecting files to print, and even controlling the X, Y, and Z axis movements to aid in leveling your bed. A single control knob lets you cycle through menu items, and selecting them by pressing the knob in. If you're looking for an FDM 3D printer that can work with both PLA and ABS that won't blow your budget up, the Creality's Ender 3 Pro is a top choice to consider. Last, we'll be looking at the FlashForge Finder, our choice for best budget 3D printer for beginners. At around $350, the FlashForge Finder is extremely easy to use, offers good print quality, making it an especially perfect choice if you're a beginner. The FlashForge Finder is an open-frame 3D printer with a single extruder. It's shaped like a cube with rounded corners and beveled top edges, and has a modest 5.5-inch print area. One thing to note, the Finder is limited to working with PLA only. However, its limit in filament materials is actually a great place to get started if you're a beginner, and by no means considered a deal breaker. Although the Finder comes fully assembled, there is some minor setup required by you. This involves loading the filament and leveling the build plate. You insert the PLA into a removable chamber in the rear of the printer and thread it up to the extruder. You then load the filament according to the instructions on the Finder's touchscreen. When the machine starts extruding filament, you'll know the loading is complete and you can move on to the next step. Once the filament is installed, you plug the printer in, turn it on, and follow the instructions for leveling the build plate from the quick start guide. The bed is pretty easy to level, and involves a semi-automatic guided process where the nozzle will move around and you'll need to tighten or loosen the screws as directed. All in all, you should be ready to start printing in about 10 minutes. In addition to the default slicing software FlashPrint that loads when the printer is powered on, you'll also be able to work with other file types like Maya, 3D Max, Tinkercar, and SketchUp to create STL files and have them exported to FlashPrint. Both STL and OBJ file formats are supported by this printer. For connectivity, the Finder makes life easier by not restricting you to SD cards like other printers. A USB stick and USB cable can be used as well. One of the best features of this printer is that it enables Wi-Fi connectivity, which means it doesn't have to be directly connected to your computer, so it doesn't have to share your computer desk space. Plus, its color touchscreen, where you make all the adjustments, is almost foolproof and easy to manage even if you're a beginner. If you're a newcomer to 3D printing and want a great printing experience learning to create from a clean-looking, super quiet, and easy-to-use printer, then the FlashForge Finder is definitely the budget 3D printer you should consider. Alright guys, that's all for now. If you enjoyed this video, please go ahead and leave a like. If you're new to the channel and you liked the video, consider subscribing. We do our best to keep you up to date with the best products on the market right now. So if you want to stay current regarding the best gear, make sure to hit that subscribe button. Be sure to check out the description for links to find the most up-to-date pricing on all the products mentioned in this video. Hope you all have a great day, and we'll see you back here soon for the next video.